in London.
Well, I asked my old pappy why he called his brew white line instead of Mountain Dew. I took a little sip and right away I knew. Well, my eyes bugged out and my face turned blue. Lightning started flashing, thunder started crashing. Ooh, white lightning.
Sweetest voice you ever heard. That's George Jones. Oh, my, George Jones on the radio. Look, I want you to sit over here for me, okay? Sit here. Ooh, I'd like it. I'll be right back. Ugh. There we go. You play with the bird. I'll be right back. Don't cry. I'll be right back.
Brought some of the family over. We're gonna use my horse to work on Daddy's car. Fix us up something to eat, huh?
Can I see the baby? You said I could see the baby.
Sure you can, huh? How you doing? I haven't seen you in so long.
Give me another inch on that chain, because I can't get it in this close.
Where I'm gonna be someday. Gonna move where the lights are shining bright. Well, anyway, that's how the song goes.
Did you make that up?
Oh, sure. I just play what comes into my head, you know, make up words.
How?
I don't know. Things I see, things I hear, even dreams.
Like what?
Well, I guess like going to Nashville someday. You know, that's where they live mostly. People like Johnny Cash and George Jones, you know, the great country singers.
You sound better than any of them.
Well, that's real sweet of you to think so, honey, but I'm better off dreaming.
Hey, Wynette, where's that big crescent wrench of mine?
I don't know.
Well, are you sure?
There's a town far away where I'm gonna be someday. Gonna move where the lights are shining bright. A big old house and brand new car. Can I really go that far? In my dreams, I see my
Wynette?
Name.
Say, baby! You sure you don't know where it is?
Got word this morning.
What?
That guy from Raymond. I got the job.
Are you telling me we're moving again?
Well, I guess so, honey. I gotta be there Monday morning. Selling farm equipment, and I got commissions. How about that?
Yeah, but we've already moved three times. If my grandparents hadn't let us use this place, I don't know what we would have done.
I'm not gonna spend my life setting out pine trees for the state government.
Well, we can't just keep moving on somewhere.
Oh, look, baby. I want you to understand something, all right? I want to get us a house. I mean a real house. With regular curtains, and a carport, and honest to goodness, indoor plumbing. Ain't that better than this? Hmm?
Hmm? I guess so.
Well, then smile.
for not writing sooner, but Upal and I are moving again. I hope we can settle down for good this time. You can't imagine how the kids have grown. Gwen's already starting nursery school.
To nursery school here, Mommy?
Sure are, honey. I'll be right back. Be careful now.
How you doing, honey?
Hi. How'd you make out?
Honey, this here job ain't worth the pigs behind. I told them that, too.
Beautiful.
I told them what they could do with their two-bit job. Now, we're gonna try out Memphis.
No.
It's a big city. They got lots of jobs there.
No.
Well, why not?
Because I just started beauty college here.
Well, you go to beauty college there.
No!
Now, look here now. If I say we're going to Memphis, then we're going to Memphis.
So you can quit the next job, and then the next one, and then the next one? I'm not moving again.
You're gonna do what I tell you to do.
You, it's always you. What about me, Upal?
Well, by God, as long as I head up this family.
Head it up? You don't even bring home enough to feed us.
Well, I'm your husband, damn it. And I'm telling you right here and now, we are going to Memphis. You hear me? Wynette? You understand me?
Well, all right. Settle then. Now get the supper on the table.
Be right back. Wynette, what'd you use on Mrs. Nichols?
The usual.
Turning kind of green. Maybe you put it on too thick. Wynette, you all right?
I think I'm gonna be sick.
How long you been pregnant?
3 months.
Well, don't show none.
I never do much.
Oh, my goodness, honey. Why didn't you tell me?
You gotta keep it a secret. They'll kick me right out of the beauty college if they find out.
Well, I wouldn't tell a soul.
I mean, Upal, too.
You're not gonna tell your own husband?
We've hit rock bottom, Upal and me. He knows I want a divorce, but he won't give it. If he finds out I'm pregnant again, he'll never give it.
I didn't know things was that bad.
4 years now, and we never settled down. We're always moving on somewhere. Most of the time, he's out of work. We never do anything. We never go any place. We don't even have a TV.
Honey, look, when you get your beauty college license, things is gonna be a whole lot different. Hey, take it easy now.
I don't know. I don't know what I'm gonna do.
You want some more potatoes? Well, are we just gonna sit here not talking?
Damn fool.
Who are you talking about?
Foreman they got. He's lucky I didn't tear into him.
ordered me around no more.
Wait a minute. Now, just wait a minute. You didn't...
They paid me. Don't worry. I got the money. I got that all right.
We're staying here. Mm-hmm. We're not moving again, Upal.
I ain't decided that yet.
I have.
I don't want to hear that kind of talk.
Then you go where you want to, but you go alone, Upal. I've only got 2 more months to finish a beauty college here, and I'm going to finish
it. Well, you just listen here.
No.
Did you hear what I said?
There's no use talking about it.
You quiet down, because you're going to wake up them kids in there. All I'm saying is that if I decide...
I don't care what you decide. Do anything you want to do, but don't include me. Let me go. It's over, you. Do anything you want to do, but just get out.
You gotta stop this.
Get out.
You hear me? You hear me? You gotta hold yourself.
It's over.
Hey, come on. Go on back to bed, baby. Go on, sweetheart. Go on back to bed.
Don't worry, Mr. Bird. The doctor says these breakdowns can be handled very simply through shock treatment.
She's had 12 treatments over here. In cases such as hers, electric shock therapy has proven enormously beneficial.
Well, here she is, ready to go home.
Hi, Helen.
You take care of yourself, Gwinnett. Call me if you need me, Mr. Bird. Good luck to both of you.
Thank you, Doc.
Hey, you look good. Really good. You feel all right? I got the car right outside. You ready to go? Here, I'll get you back. Now, Dr. Barnes says you can be just fine. He said in cases like yours, that shock treatment works real good.
Come on. Honey, your mother is some nice woman. I mean, somehow I just feel real close to her, you know? I do.
Anyway, did I tell you, this new job they're talking about is going to pay twice as much as I was making. How about that?
Things are really looking up this time. I know it for sure.
Sure is good to have you home again, baby. Ain't got much of nothing here to eat, though. Well, I'm going to go on over to the store this afternoon, pick up something. How'd you like one of them frozen pizzas? Like that?
How about that, huh? Want pizza?
You won't be staying, you. I got myself a lawyer named Harold Simpson. He's a divorce lawyer.
Ooh. Now, wait a second, baby.
I know you can fight it. You can fight it all you want to. Doesn't make any difference to me, not anymore. I'm getting a divorce, you. And I want you out of here now.
Such a long time. Who knows? Maybe he'll be back.
Mama, don't you understand? I am not taking him back. We are finished now for good.
We've never had a divorce in this family.
Well, I'm sorry, but... Look, I am not the
setting out to disgrace the family, but I sure don't want to wind up in some hospital again either.
Young couples always have their problems.
Mama, it's over.
I'm sorry, honey. If we can help out in any way, you just call on us, you hear? We only want what's best for you. You know that, don't you?
Thank you, Mama. Stay right here, okay?
Okay.
Who is it?
Police department, Mrs. Bird.
Oh, my goodness, officer, how did you know? How did you find out so soon?
I beg your pardon, ma'am. Oh,
we've been robbed.
Mrs. Bird, I have a warrant here for your arrest, if you'll just come along with me.
What? What for?
I'll explain it to you on the way to the station.
No, you don't understand. I have two little children here with me, and I can't come.
We are also taking custody of the children. This officer's from the juvenile department, and she'll take care of them for you.
No!
Mrs. Bird, I hope you don't plan on giving us any trouble. Please come with us.
Now, Mrs. Bird, about these electroshock treatments, who administered them?
Dr. Barnes, but I don't understand what it is.
Your children, Mrs. Bird. We're thinking only of your children. Your husband has charged you with being
My husband? You mean he's the one he took out a warrant for my arrest?
About these treatments.
But my God, he took everything. He robbed the apartment. Do you think I'm crazy? Dr. Pegram. Tell him, please, for God's sake, tell him I'm not crazy.
It's all right, Wynette. Tom?
You obviously know this young lady.
I should hope so. I delivered her children. It's my opinion we've been brought here together on a false alarm.
A complaint has been filed.
As a member of this board, I strongly suggest that she be released at once.
Her husband and mother have claimed
I don't care what they claim. She's perfectly sane. Well, now it's getting very late. Let's all go home. You're free to leave, Wynette.
Oh, no, I'm not going anywhere till I get my children.
Mommy! Mommy!
Oh,
how you doing? Were you scared?
I was scared.
Did you?
Oh, I'm so happy to see you.
Just because I ask a friend about her. Just because I spoke her name somewhere. Just because I rang her number.
Honestly, you sing so pretty. I never knew anyone personally could sing so pretty.
Well, thank you.
No use talking to her, Mrs. Sims. Keep telling her all the time she should be singing on the radio or the TV.
Well, it isn't that easy. You don't just walk in there and say, give me a job.
Why not? You got your Uncle Carl down in Birmingham. He works for TV stations.
He's just an engineer.
Well, I bet he knows somebody.
That must be Mrs. Richter with the kids. I'll get him.
just because
I'm not the happy guy I used to be. She thinks I still care.
But if she's happy thinking I still need her, then let that silly notion.
Where are my kids?
Mrs. Richter said that they'd already been picked up.
Picked up? By who? She didn't say. Mama, look, somebody picked up the kids from Mrs. Richter's, and I'm almost certain it was Upal. Have you talked to him at all? Did he call you?
Why, no, dear.
Well, do you know where he's living now?
No, I don't.
Well, do you know his phone number?
Well, no, I don't believe so.
Mom, are you certain you haven't talked to Upal?
Oh, there's something burning in the oven. I gotta run now.
Darling, oh, look, I want you both to come with me right away, okay? And hurry.
Wynette! Wait! Please! I'm sorry, but honest to God, darling, I was only doing it for the children. He got to talking, Upal got to talking, and he made me think that maybe you was sick again. Please, honey, if I did it all wrong, I'm sorry.
I'll see you.
Hiya, hon.
Oh, hi, Uncle Carl.
Hope I haven't kept you waiting too
long.
Oh,
no, not at all.
I'm so nervous.
Well, don't be. You come right along with me. Carl's waiting in the studio to hear you sing, and you're gonna do just fine.
Oh.
You give it all you've got. Yeah?
Gonna move where the lights are shining bright. A big old house and brand new car. Can I really go that far? In my dreams, I see my name in the online.
She's scared.
She's good. That was nice. That was real nice. You know, I got a morning show. Goes on every morning, 6 a.m. I could use a girl singer.
6 a.m.
Is that a problem?
Well, I got two kids.
Oh.
Oh, but Aunt Arlene said she'd help take care of them.
Oh, yeah.
You want the job?
Oh.
Now, what's the matter?
Well, I got another problem. I work in a beauty parlor, and I got to be there at 8:30.
You'll just make it, and we'll start you off at $35.
A show?
A week.
Well, I'll take it.
Well, you got it. Now, old country boy's got himself a new singer, Wynette Bird, and I want to tell you, she sings like a bird, too.
Trying to be myself, leaving home
again. Oh, my goodness. Look. Look, that's you on the screen.
Oh, yeah, that's my other job. I finish up there about 7:30 and get some breakfast, and then I come over here.
Oh, for goodness sakes.
Traveling on.
Are you all right?
I have to do. I've got.
What's the matter?
I'm gonna have the baby.
Oh, my, you are a busy girl.
Well, I guess I better go.
Let me help you, honey.
Oh, thank you.
Hey, Eddie, do you want to see me?
I'm working on that song again.
Oh, yeah?
Those last two bars, that was a hell of an idea of yours. They fit just right.
Well, it's a real nice song, Eddie.
Look, could I tell you something personal?
Yeah.
You are wasting your time here, Wynette, and I mean it. If there's one place in this world that you ought to be, it's in Nashville. You owe it to yourself. That's the honest truth.
Well, I don't know anybody there.
Sweetie pie, all you got to do is just open your mouth and sing, and they're going to know you soon enough.
Oh, I don't know, Eddie. I got my kids and everything.
You got your kids right here, too. Two jobs, and you're making it. You can make it in Nashville. Look, next month, it's a big disc jockey convention there. Most everybody in the business is going to be there.
I'll think about it.
Now, don't think about it. Just do it, honey.
Oh, I've done this before.
Okay. Yeah. Now, don't scare her.
I won't scare her.
Bye, sweetie.
Here you go. There you go.
Oh, girl.
Oh,
Nina, yeah. Bye,
that's
sweetheart.
It. That's it.
Bye, Mima.
Well, I'm so glad you came by. Now, don't you worry none. You're going to have a fine time in Nashville.
Now, you right, you hear?
I will.
Now, you be careful.
I will.
Take care.
Bye.
Give him three letters?
I did.
Well, what do you think?
Upal, there's no chance ever of our getting back together again, so you might just as well forget about it.
You know what I think? I think you're still crazy.
Goodbye, Upal.
Oh, well, wait a minute. Your mama told me what you're gonna do. Says you're going off to live in Nashville. Well, boy, if that ain't crazy, I don't know what is.
Thank you.
I'm gonna sing there someday, girls. Gonna come and see me?
We live it every day. What key?
Doesn't matter.
Try it, yeah.
Your cheating heart will make you weep. You'll cry and cry and try to sleep, but sleep won't. The whole night through, your cheating heart will tell on you. When tears come down like falling rain, you'll toss around and call my name. You'll walk the floor the way I do. Your cheating heart will tell on you.
That was mighty fine.
Just imagine, I only been in Nashville one day and I sung already.
It was great. You just come back anytime.
Oh, thank you. Hey.
My name is Wynette Bird, and I've recently moved here from Birmingham, and I would really like to...
Thank you.
My name is Wynette Bird. I recently moved here from Birmingham.
Is that right? You ever hear of a little town called Haleyville?
Well, I surely have. My daddy was born there.
I grew up there.
Oh!
What can I do for you?
I'd like a recording contract.
I bet you would. You got any tapes?
Tapes, no, but... Well, I can sing for you right here if you let me borrow your guitar.
If so.
Okay.
I threw away my gingham for a pretty dress of white. He wore a suit instead of faded jeans. Our wedding day was perfect and we loved away the night. Life for us was filled with lots of dreams. We bought a house up on a hill outside of town, and two young people finally settled in. And you just won't believe the little children running round. They pick yellow daisies now and then. That's the way it could have been. Oh, that's the way it should have been. If I had met you way back then, that's the way it would have been. That's the way it could have been.
It's all right. I mean you, not the song. I tell you what, you bring me a good song, a new one, and really good. I'll record you.
Goodness, oh, thank you, Mr. Cheryl, thank you.
Hey. That's my guitar.
Oh, sorry.
Say, what'd you say your name was again?
Wynette Bird.
Is that the name you're gonna use?
Well, there's my maiden name, Pew.
Pew. Well, you know, you look kinda like a Tammy to me. Why don't you try that?
With what, Wynette?
Why not?
Tammy Wynette.
Not bad.
Tammy Wynette. Okay. Thank you.
Which one you going with first, Billy? The one she brought in?
No, this one, it came in a couple of days ago. It's a whole lot better song. Tammy?
Honey, we're about ready to make one.
All right, boys, y'all about ready? Crank it up.
Just follow the stairway to this lonely world of mine. You'll find me waiting here in apartment number 9. Not so very long
Where
ago.
Where did she come from?
Did walk in at all?
Billy, that's the damnedest little female singer I ever heard in my life.
And after all the plans we made, you decided to be free. Loneliness surrounds me without your arms around me. And apartment number 9. Just follow the stairway to this lonely world of mine. You'll find me waiting here in apartment number 9.
That was Tammy Wynette with her new hit, Apartment Number 9, which moved right into the top of the charts.
Mommy?
What?
Why can't you sing in just one city?
Because they don't do it like that, honey. You gotta go to different nightclubs and different county fairs, things like that. So people get to know you, get to know your singing.
Where are we now?
Well, we're in, I'm not sure. Did you want peanut butter and jelly, Jackie?
Mm-hmm.
Here you go.
Me and little J.O.E. will be going away. I love you both in this world.
You did it again.
What?
Moved to number one in the charts.
Oh!
That's not good news.
What are you talking about?
How'd you like to sing with George Jones?
Billy, are you joking?
Yeah, well, not with him exactly, but on the same show. See, now, you'll come on first with a big introduction and then do your duet with Houston, and Jones will do the rest of the show.
Oh, well, I think I'd do it for nothing.
No, we won't, not with three hits under our belt.
Okay, so after the intro, we'll bring them up.
Come in.
Tammy, you can relax.
I beg your pardon?
Got plenty of time. David Houston is going on first. He's got to get away early to catch a plane.
Oh, well, what about our duet?
Oh, you can still do it.
How? I mean, if I don't go on first, I won't have any introduction. Want me just to go out there and sing? That doesn't seem right.
I don't see any big problem.
Well, we could do the duet as the first song on my show, and then he can get away early.
He's not going to want to be a part of somebody else's show.
Well, it just doesn't seem right to me.
Just do it.
I don't believe I will.
Well, I think you better if you want to use his band.
I paid for them. They're getting extra money to play for me.
Sorry.
Look. Just because I'm a girl singer, that doesn't mean...
Now, everybody knows how girl singers make it in this business.
Are you ready, George? We're going on early.
Huh?
We're going on early.
Why?
Well, Houston's almost finished.
Well, what about Tammy Wynette?
She ain't going on.
Call her for me, would you? What do you say ain't going on? Why not?
I don't know. Something about her. Introduction.
Introduction?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, you gave me the reason to start giving. When I became the man worth loving you. Yes, you gave me the reason to keep living. And made me a thousand faith in what I do. Yes, you gave me the reason to start giving. When I became the man worth loving you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I've had the privilege of recording with, I guess, the best girl singers in the world, and I love all of them. But there's a young lady here tonight that I think I would rather sing a duet with than anybody I can think of. You think we might be able to persuade her to come out here and sing a duet with me? Because I'm talking about the one and only Tammy Wynette. The funny thing about this is that She was supposed to do this thing with someone else who shall remain nameless. But I think I can fill in for him if I can just remember the words. And you know what? She not only sings like an angel, she looks like one, doesn't she?
Okay, boys, lucid dreams.
I followed you to Texas. I followed you to Utah.
But we didn't find it there. So we moved on.
Is that right?
I went with you to Alabama. Things look good in Birmingham.
We didn't find it there, so we moved on.
I know. Tired of following.
Okay.
Wait up a minute, would you? I don't know about you. I had a hell of a good time tonight.
Oh, I can't thank you enough.
We got, like, you know, three more dates on this tour, and I was thinking maybe we could do it again. I promise I get the words right.
Well, I think they like it better the way we did it.
So, can we call out a deal then?
It would be my pleasure, Mr. Jones.
That's George to you.
Good night, George.
Good night.
It's like heaven to be near you.
Times when we're apart and I can't face my heart. My hours could be spent near you.
I'd be more than content
near you.
Make my life worthwhile by telling me that I'll spend the
How are they?
Well, they're okay. Doctor says they're gonna be good in the morning, something they ate.
She get any hot dogs?
No.
Nah, we probably overdid the hot dogs in the park.
George, let me take that. Well, you didn't have to come all the way over here.
Well, I just sort of felt like it, you know, just did it.
Well, they are asleep now, so I... Oh, spoke too soon.
I got a guy in here who wants to play with the band. I do. You want to see if he's any good? Just call him this up. Say, we see if he can play any. Huh? Mr. Bear, Mr. Bear.
Your hair's mighty brown. Yes, bless God, it's put on wrong. And every little soul must shine, shine. Every little soul must shine, shine. You hold on that now. You go to sleep here.
Get out my George Jones records and put him to sleep that way.
You don't have to. I know it's not a time to talk about how I feel about you. But I think you know.
Yeah. If you watch as the heart of a child breaks in two, then you've seen a picture of me without you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you all. Thank you, Boris. I'm gonna be back in just 1 minute. With somebody I want you all to meet, okay?
You're not nervous, are you?
Yes, I am.
Give me your little hand. I got just what you need.
George.
Oh, well, we'll get a bigger one later on. Don't worry. Come on.
Appreciate it. Thank you very much. This is a very special occasion for a very dear person in my life. And this is the first time for her here on the stage at the Grand Ole Opry. I'd like you to make her feel real welcome. Give her a big hand. Miss Tammy Wynette. Well, they ain't gonna bite you, you know. I mean, I might, but they won't. Come on, say something to them. Go on.
Excuse
wait
me.
Wait a minute here.
I'm still pinching myself. I've been thinking, Tammy, you're gonna be right up there. Right there on the stage of the Grand Ole Opry House. It's a dream I've had since I was a little girl back in my granddaddy's farm in Mississippi. I'm standing right here where Hank Williams and Red Foley and all the greats have stood.
By George Jones.
And George Jones. You wouldn't let me say it on my own, but the reason I'm up here tonight, the reason that you've all made me feel so welcome, that I am up here with the greatest country music singer that ever lived.
Well, who she could be talking about, do you? Let's give them a little something about what they come for.
By a fountain back in Rome, I fell in love with you. In a small cafe in Athens, you said you loved me too.
And it was April in Paris when I first held you close to me.
Rome, Georgia.
Athens, Texas.
And Paris, Tennessee.
No, we're not the Jetsons.
There's no Riviera in Festus, Missouri. And you won't find Onassis in Martinville, Kansas. No, we're not the jet set, we're the old Chevrolet set. But ain't we got love?
Waiting for the greatest country music singer in America, Mr. George Jones.
Where's George?
I think we better do another number.
It looks like, George won't be with us this evening. I'm sorry.
What is he?
This is a number that I recorded, and folks seem to like it real well.
Hey, George!
Go with George!
Hey,
lady!
Hey, Tammy,
you're paying for George, too.
Where is he?
Sat alone at the window, and I watched a little girl outside at play with a little boy.
I didn't give my money for this one person.
I want George.
We want George.
Show with two people.
Come on,
Tammy.
Come on,
Tammy. Just bring George out.
He went off with the club owner on a toot somewhere together. Sometimes, I mean, if he goes off on a really big drunk, he'll be gone most a week, you know, trapping all over drinking and stuff. But he always comes back. Yeah, I know what you're thinking, but... Well, to me, George Jones is the kindest, most generous man I ever work with, and I love him like a brother. Hey, look at the bright side. I mean, if he's out drinking with the club owner, at least we can't get sued.
Hey, you.
George. Oh, George. Do you know how long you've been gone?
Couple of days.
3 days.
Look, me and McMahon got an airplane, and we hit a couple of spots.
Where?
Never mind. Get up. We got a lot to do today, girl. Come on. Because this is the day, Mrs. Jones. I mean, a lot of people think that we are married. I think we ought to back them up on it.
Wow, George!
Don't scream in my ear like that.
This year's award for the Country Music Association's female vocalist, the winner is Miss Tammy Wynette.
I would like to thank Mr. Billy Sherrill, who believed in me, and everybody who voted for me. And most of all, I'd like to thank Mr. George Jones.
dress up fancy.
See, what I tell you, ain't she wonderful? Ain't she beautiful?
Sings like an angel.
Yeah, I struck it rich and got me the best little wife in the whole world.
Think that way when you're working?
Oh, come on, Mom.
You was drinking all evening.
A couple of swallows.
What's going on, George? You fixing to treat her the way your daddy did me? Is that how you want to live?
I ain't him.
I can see what you're doing, George. George!
I said I ain't him.
Cigarette out, it's making me sick.
Making you sick? It never made you sick before.
Yeah, it did. 3 times. With Gwen first, and then Jackie, and then Tina.
With Gwen first, and then Jackie, and then Tina. Are we gonna be Mama and Daddy?
I think so.
Oh, my good girl. My good girl.
Come on, get out of there. Come on. I mean, did you ever see anything like that? That's a beauty, isn't it?
Well, who lives here?
Well, that's what I was going to talk to you about.
George, are you trying to tell me you're thinking of buying this place?
No, I already bought it. Come here now, look, here's the back. Upstairs, there's 6 bedrooms. There's a recreation room, there's a library, there's a formal dining room, there's a place we can make into a brand new nursery.
Oh, I mean, it's gonna take a fortune to keep a place like this.
No, I got that all figured out. Now, there's 43 acres that's adjacent to this property that we can buy, and it's got like a natural shape type bowl deal in it, like an amphitheater, you know? And we'd put up bleachers, and we'd put on shows every weekend. No, I mean, not just us, but everybody. We get the biggest names in the business. And we'll call it the Old Plantation Country Music Park. And the house, I mean, is perfect for the kids. Now, come on, what do you think?
Oh, I love it.
You love it. I thought you'd love
it. George, watch the baby.
Oh, I'm sorry. Come here inside.
Yeah, we got them all booked. Got Merle Haggard and Charlie Pride, and we got Johnny Cash.
Guess this puts you on the map, all right.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
I'm bringing the crib in here. I ain't gonna have my little baby darling sleeping all over there in some room all by herself.
Looks like you fixed up the nursery for her.
Come on, honey. Come to Daddy. You're gonna sleep right in here with us.
You're gonna spoil her.
Yeah, I am. Spoil her real good, too.
Good morning, Mr. Jones.
Morning.
Mrs. Jones. We got your suite all set up for you.
Hey,
we got our fingers crossed you're going to win tonight.
Oh, thank you.
No slam. How you doing, buddy?
Just fine, just fine. You in town for the Broadcast Music Awards?
Oh, I believe there's some messages for you. Messages for the Joneses, please.
Thank you.
Come on.
Honey, why don't you stay here and make sure we're all settled in and everything's okay? Slim's got some stereo stuff he's going to show me, and I'll be back in a couple hours, okay?
Stenographer, we didn't order us. Thank you. You waiting for George Jones?
That's right, honey. Who are you?
I'm Mrs. Jones, honey.
Oh.
Mr. Jones won't be joining you.
My boss told me to wait for him here.
Who in the hell do you think you are?
George.
You sent somebody away to come here to see me, you know that? You don't say who I can see or when I can see him.
George, if you're...
You don't tell me where to go or when to go there. You don't tell me what to do. Nobody tells me what to do.
George,
nobody!
George, you're shouting and people are gonna hear us.
Yeah. I'm getting a little loud, huh? Getting a little too loud. Nobody tells me what to do. Nobody.
And now, we come to the awards honoring BMI writers and publishers whose songs have been most performed in the past year. You've heard the nominees. And the winner is Tammy Wynette. Or Stand By Your Man.
Thank you. I'm very proud that you voted for me. Well, I thank you. You're doing, George? You're killing off what we have little by little. Can you understand that?
It ain't gonna happen again. That's a promise. Ain't never gonna happen again.
Music park, your house full of kids and everything, but well, the last album just sold over a million copies. So if you could see your way clear to doing a couple of gigs in Vegas next month, we could.
George, sweetheart, the baby has to have her nap now.
What do you mean have a nap? Who said she had to have a nap?
I said so.
All right, Mama always wins. No, you can't play it anymore. No,
take it.
That's all right, honey. I'll take her up. Can't play the piano when Mama says we have to have a nap.
Is he still drinking?
Yeah, off and on. You just never know. Sometimes he's fine, and then all of a sudden he'll drink for days.
I didn't know it was that bad.
Only last week he drank everything in sight, and I was afraid that he was going to take one of the cars and go to the bar, so I hid all the car keys. But it didn't work because he snuck out and he drove 13 miles on the power lawnmower.
What are you going to do?
I don't know. I don't want to lose him. I just want to lose what's happening to him.
Well, there's everything I can do. You know, anything at all.
I know. And these are the receipts for the last 2 months?
Yes, that's right.
Did you show them to George?
Not yet. I wanted to, but he wasn't there earlier, not at the office anyway.
Oh, well, maybe he went down by my folks at the River Road.
Well, do you want to hold off going over the second ledger until he gets
here? Yeah, let's do that.
I think you better come.
What's the matter?
He's back in here. I think he needs your help.
Huh? What?
Get outside.
Nuts!
here quick. George has a gun. He's breaking up the house.
You want me to bring the police?
I don't care who you bring. Just come over quick.
Yes, I had a long talk with him this morning. He says he doesn't remember a thing. I'm inclined to believe him.
Doctor, this is the worst he's ever been.
Yes, I'm sure it is. We had to put him in a padded cell. I'm going to keep him here at the hospital for 10 days with no visitors. I want time to get his head clear as well as his body. After that, it's up to George and to you. He has simply got to stop drinking.
He's coming up the drive now, and I'm scared.
Oh, don't be silly.
I just don't understand. I mean, to leave everything the way he left it?
How else is he going to know what he's done?
What are you looking for? I've got no bottles back here.
You might find some vodka in the orange grove, though. I know for a fact you've been hiding it there and make yourself a screwdriver with fresh orange juice. I'm gonna file for a divorce.
Tammy.
I know what you're gonna say. Same three things you always say. You're sorry, you'll never do it again, and you love me.
Listen, we're going to work this out.
How? By you killing yourself? You might as well put a gun to your head and get it over with right now.
Now, this time?
This time. Well, maybe you do love me, George, but not enough. Not enough to stop drinking.
You got to listen to me. I cannot lose you.
Then why do you keep trying to so hard? That's what I don't understand. Why?
No more.
That's no answer.
Got to believe me. This time, it's no more.
Well, how can I believe you? You think I want a divorce? I just want my husband. But I can't live like this, George.
I know that. I know it's going to be almost impossible for you to believe, but I'm going to change. I'm going to get some help with this thing, and I've been thinking that, you know, too much work around here for us to handle. It's like we've taken on too much. We ought to go and move on back to Nashville and be near where it's all happened. I mean, if you could just put all that bad stuff behind us, and there's not gonna be any more drinking. And you got to give me that chance. Please do it. Please.
We're gonna hold on. We're gonna hold on.
Like this anymore.
We've had three cancellations. People want to see you together. Both of you. I'm sorry. I might be able to get you the Muskie College Auditorium on the 30th.
I don't know what I want to do now.
Why not? What's the matter? You scared? What are you afraid of? Tammy, I remember the first time you came in this office. Didn't have a dime to your name. Three kids outside in the car. Went over there and picked up my guitar. And you sang a song for me. Just you alone. You're a star now, Tammy. You can do it on your own. Anytime.
He's right. Man could sure use the work, Tammy. George says he ain't gonna do anything, not for a long while anyways. Hoping we could keep right on with you.
I don't know.
Well, either way, we understand.
I just keep thinking if I had been prettier or smarter or something, he wouldn't have gone on like that.
You did what you could, Tammy.
Well, I don't know what I'm gonna do now.
Boys are ready. Anytime you are.
I thank both of you from my heart.
I've had the privilege of recording with, I guess, the best girl singers in the world, and I love all of them. But there's a young lady here tonight that I think I would rather sing a duet with than anybody I can think of. You think we might be able to... Wait her to come out here and sing a duet.
It's George on the phone.
I'm talking about the one and only.
He's in Nashville. He wants to come home.
Tell him he's got no home to come to.
I think that's something you better tell him yourself.
I'm taking the kids away for a week. You can come pick up your things anytime.
Baby, wait a minute.
Now get me a box. A big box.
What for? What are you doing?
I'm getting rid of George.
Gentlemen, there's a lady who started singing not too far from here in Itawamba County. Let's give a nice warm welcome now. The first lady of country music, Miss Tammy Wynette. Now, we don't know where George is. Nobody knows where George is. George doesn't even know where George is.
Excuse me. That's Charlie Carter talking to you. And, what he's saying is mostly true. I mean, if I didn't know where George was when we were married, I sure don't know where he is now. But, I will tell you one thing, though. Even though I just couldn't live with George, he still is the greatest singer in country music today. There's a song I wrote. Some of you may have heard it. It may not seem right to be singing it now, but I still do believe in it. At least I believe it's the way it should be.
Sometimes it's hard to be a woman, giving all your love to just one man. You'll have bad times, and he'll have good times, doing things that you don't understand. But if you love him, you'll forgive him, even though he's hard to understand. And if you love him, oh, After all, he's just a man. Are cold and lonely.